This video is to go along with lesson 1.4, and we're going to call this Name Angles and Terms. We're going to start out with how to name angles. Angles, first of all, are made up of two rays. Ray is like half of a line. It starts at a point and it continues indefinitely in one direction. So if we name a couple of these, the rays making up this angle would be QS, and when you name a ray, you begin with the letter of the point where the ray begins, which begins at Q, and then you draw one single arrow pointing in one direction, always to the right, so that's why we put Q first. And the other ray making this angle is QZ. And they come together at point Q, which is called the vertex. One way to name this angle would be simply by an angle symbol and the letter Q, the vertex point. We also could name this angle, angle SQZ, or another way would be angle ZQS. Important to keep that Q in the middle of your three letters. So you can change the order, but the Q needs to be in the middle. Sometimes angles are also given a number right here in the interior. So we could also even call this angle 1 or whatever number is in that area, that interior angle. Now, all of these ways are fine, except for sometimes it doesn't make sense to name an angle with a single letter. So I'll show you what I'm talking about. Let's look at this other picture here that we're given, this in black. If we were to refer to an angle in this diagram as angle T, would you know which angle in that picture I was talking about? Of course not. There are multiple angles at point T, so it does not work in this case to use a single letter to name an angle. So you would have to name an angle, let's take this one here, with three letters. So angle RTS, or you could reverse it and STR. That would work. Or if there was a number hanging around there in the interior of that angle, we could call that angle too. All right, a couple of terms that I want you to get into your foldable. I'm going to write them up here. You need to look up and define an acute angle, an obtuse angle, a right angle, and lines that are perpendicular. You are probably already familiar with these words, but go ahead and pause the video, look these terms up either in your textbook or in your online textbook. You can click the glossary button at the top and look these up, and then you can continue the video in a minute. Hopefully you're joining us again and you have already defined these four terms in your foldable, and we are going to continue with terms on here talking about them together. I want to also define something called vertical angles. You can also put this in your foldable. But vertical angles are angles that are formed by two straight lines, straight, 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 and angles that are across from each other, like these two here that I'm marking in red. Those would be considered vertical angles. Also, in this X formed by the red line, there would be another pair of vertical angles, which would be going across this way. Notice when I mark those that I'm combining these angles over here together into one angle to get our vertical pair. Vertical angles are always, always, always congruent. Let's talk about how I mark that for a minute. When you mark angles congruent, if you use the same markings, like a single crescent like that, that indicates that those two angles with the same mark are congruent. Or going the other way with these double crescent marks, that indicates that those two are congruent. You could also even put like a little tick mark in there, however you want to do that to indicate that the angles are congruent. I want to point out here that sometimes you may see a drawing where it looks like lines intersecting, but maybe one of those lines is not straight. It does not continue straight. These angles here are not vertical. No, no, because they are not being joined by two straight lines. Okay, another term besides vertical angles are going to be adjacent angles. I'm sure in your house that you have rooms that are adjacent to each other. Here in school, my classroom is adjacent to Mr. Hayward's classroom because our rooms share a wall. Angles that are adjacent share a ray. So let's look at angle LTN, and we'll do a different color here, and angle NTE. Those two angles both share this ray TN, so those two angles there are adjacent. They're not necessarily congruent, but they're just next to each other. Then we also have a straight angle, and a straight angle is one that is just a straight line, as you might have guessed. And how many degrees do you think a straight angle is? That's right, it's 180 degrees. Then, in the same picture, let's put a couple other letters or points on here. Ray SQ starts at S and go towards Q, and ray SZ beginning at S and going towards Z. Also in that diagram, let me put these letters back up here. We said that that was 180 degrees, making a straight line. Ray QZ, starting at Q and going towards Z, and also ray QT, are opposite rays. That's another term that you need to put down in your foldable. Opposite rays form a straight angle, and they point exactly opposite from each other, and they form 180 degrees. One more thing here is going to be, let's get rid of this, angle bisector. That is pretty much self-explanatory, but a ray can be an angle bisector if it is cutting a bigger angle perfectly in half. So let's take angle LTE and imagine that ray TN is bisecting it, cutting it exactly in half. If an angle is bisected and it's exactly in half, that means that these two new angles that are formed have equal and congruent angle measures. So we could say that angle LTN is congruent or equal to angle NTE. One last term that I forgot to put in there is a linear pair. A linear pair are angles that are adjacent to each other, and they form a straight line. For instance, the angle I have highlighted in green, RTL, and the angle highlighted in blue, LTE, are lying along a straight line here. So those would be considered a linear pair. Linear has the word line in it, so they lie on a straight line. So make sure that you have all the information in your foldable and your notebook.